particle size by microscopic method. So in case of microscopic method, the particles in the range of 0.2 to 100 microns can be measured. By using this method, we can measure the particle size in the range of 0.2 to 100 microns. And in this method, the particle size is expressed as the dp, okay, projected diameter. The particle size is expressed as projected diameter. What is meant by projected diameter? It is the diameter of the sphere having a same surface as that of a symmetric particle when observed under the microscope. Microscope was used up to. So the spherical particle as well as our asymmetric particle both are having a same surface area. Those are known as the projected diameter. So the next one is this method. In this method, the particle size distribution is expressed as number distribution. Number distribution. Whereas in sieving method, the distribution is expressed as weight distribution. In case of microscopy, the distribution is expressed as number distribution. So what is meant by number distribution means? So the number of particles which are present in each size range. Number of particles present in each size range. For example, we take a 0 to 5 microns and 5 to 10 microns. In case of 0 to 5 microns, how many particles will be present? 10. For example, and 5 to 10 microns, if there is a 20 particles, like that, the number of particles in each size range is known as number distribution. And in case of microscopic method, we can take the samples of liquid formulations. Mostly this method is suitable for liquid formulations. This method is suitable for liquid formulations like either it may be emulsions, or suspensions, or diluted powders. Diluted powders. This method is suitable for mostly liquid formulations. Either we can take emulsion, suspension, or diluted powders. And in this method, we use eyepiece micrometer and stage micrometers. So in case of sieve analysis, what we used? Sieve shaker we used. Where there is a standard sieve will be present. Whereas in case of microscopic method, we use the two types of micrometers as scales. One is an eyepiece micrometer and the other one is a stage micrometer. So coming to the advantages of this method, advantages of this method include, so we can visualize the particles. We can view the particles directly. There is a visibility of particles. We can view the particles. The next one is, if there is any agglomeration, aggregation of the particle if there is present, or is there any contamination of the product, we can observe or we can detect in the samples. So if there is any agglomeration, is there any agglomeration or contamination in the sample, it can be detected. And the third application is, and it is a simple and easy method, simple and easy method when comparing to the remaining two methods, that is the sedimentation and conductivity method. But when comparing to the sieving method, it is a somewhat difficult method. So compared to the remaining two methods, like sedimentation and conductivity method, it is a simple method. So coming to the disadvantages include, we can measure the particles in two dimensions only. So we measure the particles in two dimensions. We can measure length and width of the sample, width of the particle. We cannot measure the depth of the particle. We cannot measure the depth of the particles. So here the disadvantages include, the particle will be measured in terms of two dimensions, that is in terms of length and width. We want to measure the depth of the particles. So that is the one disadvantage. And the next one is, it is a difficult method, it is a tedious method. It is a very difficult method because to get the accurate results, we need to measure 625 particles. To get the accurate results, we need to measure 625 particles by observing under microscope. It takes a long time. It is a slow process also. It is a slow and tedious method. So that much of particles cannot be measured at a time by seeing under microscope. That's why it is a tedious method. So this is about the microscopic method. So we can measure 0.2 to 100 microns, and the particle size is expressed as projected diameter, and the distribution is expressed as the number distribution, and mostly suitable for liquid formulations. And in this method we use eyepiece micrometer and stage micrometer, and in this method we can directly view the particles. If there is any contamination or agglomeration, it can be detected, and it is a simple method when compared to conducting living materials. So whereas we can measure the particle in only two dimensions, that is in length and width, we can't measure the depth of the particle. And it is a slow and tedious method, and to get the accurate results, more than 500 particles, that is 625 particles, has to be determined. So coming to the procedure, in the procedure there are three steps will be present. The first one is the calibration of eyepiece micrometer. Calibration of eyepiece micrometer using stage micrometer. That is the first step. And the second one is the preparation of the sample. Second step is the preparation of sample. The third step is the detection or determination of particle size. Determination of or measurement of particle size. Determination of particle size. Stage micrometer which is similar to that of glass slide, but at the center it is having a standard scale. At the center there is a circle will be present, so glass slide will be present. At the center there is a circle, within the circle there is a scale will be present, that is a standard scale. And the scale having a length of 1 mm length. And here the scale is divided into 100 divisions. The scale is divided into 100 divisions. That means each division is equals to, so actually the length is a 1 mm length, and it is divided into 100 divisions. Now each division is equals to 0.01 millimeter, or we can say that 10 micrometers. So this is also known as the least count of stage micrometer. Least count. So here stage micrometer is similar to that of normal glass slide. At the center it is having a scale. This scale having a length of 1 mm. And it is divided into 100 parts. And each part is equals to the 10 micrometers. micrometers. The 10 micrometers is known as least count of the stage micrometer. The next one is the eyepiece micrometer, which is similar to that of, this is the eyepiece micrometer, which is similar to that of the normal eyepiece. This is the normal eyepiece, this is the eyepiece micrometer. So, normal eyepiece, the eyepiece micrometer, it is also having a scale. The length of this scale, eyepiece having a scale, the length of this scale is 10 mm. The length of the scale is 10 mm. It is also divided into 100 divisions, and each division, one division is equals to mostly the 0.1 mm. Each division is equals to 0.1 mm. And here, the calibration of eyepiece micrometer using a stage micrometer involves, first initially, the steps include, first initially, we need to take the stage micrometer, which is placed on the stage of the microscope. So first we need to take stage micrometer placed on the stage of the micrometer. And now, replace the eyepiece should be replaced with the eyepiece micrometer. And now, when we observe under microscope, initially we need to focus under lower magnification. Initially, scale is focused under lower magnification, that is under 10x. If it is visible under 10x, now it should be shifted to 45x. The higher magnification we need to shift. So when we observe under a 45x, it will be visible as, so here the visibility of the eyepiece and stage micrometer. So if you see the eyepiece micrometer, this is the eyepiece micrometer, which can be observed as, so the divisions will be numbered as 0, 10, 20.
Divisions are 3. We need to count the number of stage
and eyepiece divisions may be 10. So in the least count we know the 10 micrometers, right? So finally the calibration factor is 3 micrometers. 10 cancel, 3 micrometers. So this is the first step and most important. If you did not do the calibration perfectly, your results will be inaccurate. So that's why the calibration of eyepiece micrometer include. So the first one is place the stage micrometer on the stage of microscope, and after that place the eyepiece and focus under the 10x initial. Later when we observe the scales, then move on to 45x. Now after moving on to 45x, adjust the eyepiece and the stage micrometer, both are parallel to each other. And now select any two coincide points, two intercept points we need to be select. So they are recommended 10 or 20, so whatever it is, two intercept points will be selected. And count the number of divisions in these two points. Here for example, these two are the coincide points. We rendered madhya any divisions in the count chestam. So on the stage micrometer, mostly less number, 3, and eyepiece divisions are more, so it may be 10. Then the calibration factor is equals to 3 micrometers. Here the calibration factor is nothing but stage micrometer divisions by eyepiece divisions into least count. So this is the first step. And coming to the second step, the preparation of the sample. Each particle in terms of divisions. For example, this is there is a need to convert these divisions into micrometers. So for conversion of the divisions into micrometer, so again we need to draw the table of 10 into 10 and each division is multiplied with micrometer, that is a calibration factor. So already we get a calibration of 3 micrometers, right? The number of divisions into the micrometer is equal to division into calibration factor. For example, first one is 5 divisions. 5. We get a calibration factor of 3. So first particle, if you want to convert into micrometers, lo convert cheyali ante, how many divisions? 5. What is the calibration factor? 3. That is equal to 15 micrometers. So the first particle size will be whatever we counted. The first particle size is 15 microns, whereas this size will be 3 into 3, 9 micrometers, 10 into 3, 30 micrometers. Like that, number of particles, 100 particles should be measured in terms of divisions, and now these divisions are converted into micrometers by multiplying with the calibration factors. So this is a practical procedure. So after that, the calibration of particle size, now this data is converted into number of parameters. So here the total table is divided into different size ranges. Now finally we need to make a table. The first one is size range and the next one is midpoint B. And next one is number of particles, that is a frequency, the percent frequency N, and the next column is N into D, and finally the percent cumulative undersize, oversize, and percent cumulative undersize. So we need to convert whatever the data we get from the experiment, convert it into different parameters. So we have the different sizes. All these sizes should be divided into different ranges. The first one is 0 to 10 micrometers, 10 to 20 micrometers, 20 to 30 micrometers, 30 to 40, up to whatever you get, the highest micrometer. The highest micrometers. So in the results, whatever you get, the highest results, up to that, we need to convert the data into different size ranges. First 0 to 10 micrometers. 0 to 5, midpoint means 5 micrometers. 0 plus 10 by 2, that's a 5. 10 plus 20, 30 by 5, 30 by 2, 50. 20 plus 30, 50 by 2, 25 micrometers. So this is the midpoint of the size range. The next one is N. N is nothing but number of particles. So we need to, we need to count 0 to 10 micrometers, so any particles which we count here. We need to count the particles, how many which are belongs to in the range of 0 to 10 micrometers. So all the particles should be counted in the range of 0 to 10. For example, it may be 10 or 20 particles. So the next 10, 15, it may be 12 particles. The next in the range, 15 particles. Like that, the total particles should be divided into different size ranges. The next one is percent N. Mostly we are taking percent N, and the meaning is the number of particles divided by total number into 100. So here we measured total number of particles are, in our experiment, total number of particles are 100. 100 cancel out only. So finally, the percent N is equal to frequency. So here also 10, 12, 15. And next one is N into D column. D values, both should be multiplied and we get a N into D values. And finally, the percent cumulative oversize. So if you add the percent frequency, this is the column, percent frequency from the top. So that means 10 plus 12, 22 plus 15, 37. Like that, if you add from the top to bottom, we get a oversized particles. If you add from the bottom, we get undersized particles. So after calibrating all those things, we need to the y-axis and we get a bell shaped curve. And the next one is the d on x-axis and percent cumulative undersize, percent cumulative oversize on both axes of the y, and then we get a two S-shaped curves. The intersect point will indicate the average value. And finally, third graph, log of b value, log of b on x-axis and percent cumulative undersize, then you get a straight line. So just simply the S-shaped curves are converted into the straight line. And calculate the slope of this by taking any two points randomly, x1, y1, x2, y2, and calculate the slope, m value. The m is equal to slope is equal to standard deviation. And whereas from the formula, if you want to calculate the particle size, the formula the way formula is just the average is equal to, the average is also known as mean value, m to indicate this. The average m is equal to the sigma of n into d by sigma of n. So here there is a column of n into d. If you sum all the values, we get sigma of n into d. Similarly, we have a column of n. Sigma of n can be calculated. And substitute those two values in this formula, we can get the particle size in micrometers. So this is the experiment on particle size and size distribution by the microscopic method. So we have the three steps. The calibration, preparation of the sample, and determination or measurement of the particle size. In case of calibration, simply focus eyepiece and strain micrometer under 45x and select any two coincide points, and we need to count the number of divisions on those two points. Two points lo any divisions unnayo count chestam. Finally, calibration factor is equals to stage divisions by eyepiece divisions into least count vaste, you get a calibration factor. Next, sample preparation. So simply powder you can take and add 1 or 2 drops of liquid paraffin and distribute uniformly and focus at 45 degrees. Now we can visualize the particles as like this, and we need to count the particles in terms of divisions by using eyepiece. We need to remove the stage micrometer. Stage micrometer remove jaisi. In that we place the glass slide. Manam sample prepare jaisi glass slide padna. Focus jaisi the particles ila kanipistayi. And divisions count jaisi. Now these divisions are multiplied with the calibration factor. We can get the particles in terms of micrometers. Now all these particles are converted into different size ranges. And we need to count in each size range number of particles. And finally, we need to plot a graph of these three. From the first graph, we can understand which percentage of particles will be present in each size range. In second graph, we can get the value of average particle diameter. From the third graph, we can get the standard deviation value. And the next one is from the formula sigma of n into d by sigma of n, we can get the particle size directly. So finally, you need to report three parameters. One is the particle size diameter from the formula. The particle size was found to be from the graph. And the next is standard deviation. And the third one is type of distribution. Here the type of distribution.